Good to see you.
Thank you very much. Governor Herschler from Wyoming is going to join us.
I didn't twist your arm. You have no reason. Well, come in and...
Thank you, Mr.
I apologize for living like... A little problem with the necktie here.
Yes, I can see that'd be a real problem.
First place, my neck is sore, and I won't stand it. The second place, I can't tie one, so...
Well, you can't tie one with one hand. That never thought of it before.
We're very appreciative of you being here. I mean, I'm afraid that I probably slipped to start out on my first visit with you. Mr. Secretary, thank you very much for...
Thank you, sir.
...for joining us. Governor Herschler and I realize how important your time is, and we're very honored to have this opportunity to meet with you.
Well, pleased to meet with you.
I have a book that I would like to leave for you and your staff, and we have, this is a result of the meeting that we had in Dallas, and it's a report. I'll just give it to you, put it over there. It's a nation in need of energy security, and while it's submitted by me, it's prepared by the Interstate Oil Compact Commission as a result of the six governors that met in Dallas and several governors that weren't able to be there, but many of them who support our position. But it really is just something that we ask your people to review. It's not anything we ask you to comment on today or anything like that.
Well, I know it's in the resolution you passed, and I just made a couple of notes here.
Okay.
Because we're not all that far apart. We are, with regard to the American oil tax or tariff or something, we think there are other answers, but I've already, and an announcement has come out today, I've already today stated that we're going to reaffirm and go after again deregulation of natural gas.
Excellent.
Would be, I hope, repeal of the Fuel Use Act of 1979.
Philadelphia was all wet last night.
Well, Bob, I want to thank you very much for putting off the committee meeting to come down here today, and thank all of you for coming down on such short notice. We know what the subject is about. Jack, you wrote me, and the others who signed the letter, I indicated that I couldn't go along with what had been proposed. I noticed a number of you already, I've tried to explain what I see as the seriousness of this with regard to our relations with Canada and with the Prime Minister up there, who has gotten himself in deep political trouble just from trying to be a good friend to the United States, to the point that there are political opponents who are accusing him of rolling over and playing dead. And this, I think that his own ability to do things and continue to cooperate is hanging on this particular issue. And I just want to tell you that you've got my commitment that Clinton will be working with you every step of the way as we conduct the negotiations on all the trade irritants that exist between the United States and Canada. And if we don't initiate these negotiations in the manner that I have requested, we'll be jeopardizing the tone, I think, of our political and economic relationship very seriously and for years to come. And having a denial, the fast track on the eve of our trip to Tokyo won't be helpful, because at issue there are going to be a number of things we're going to try to resolve that are still trade irritants where we're concerned, and interferences with the free and fair trade that we would like to see established worldwide. And I don't see if I have to go there and haven't been able to do something with our strongest ally and our greatest trading partner, I doubt that I will have very much a weight with those who are sitting around the table. But there may be other things on your mind, those of you who come here today, and so I'd like to hear from you what it is and what we can do to try and resolve this issue.
President,
this is Mercedes.
Thank you.
bus of Indonesia, and yet from Straight Times of Singapore.
Well, I won't be out of you, there isn't one of the time I've come over since this is accompanying the written interview. Why don't we sit down in those chairs for the picture so it looks like we're here.
You can leave your bag right there. Oh, you can take off your pass to do it with the other.
All right.
Have you heard about the Gaddafi choke?
No.
It says that Gaddafi was mad at his children. The answer is they came home and they were bombed. I'm sorry I didn't say it well. But I hope you know this is the newest joke
here. Well,
do you want to have a present?
Could you find this? Oh, no. I think this is the year when I came to watch it.
Yeah.
I'll be doing this my first assignment.
I have the original of that hanging up in the gym upstairs in the White House. Is this 21 just my name?
Just your name.
Just my name. Yes, I am.
Have you been there before?
No, I've been to Indonesia before to see two women.
There's
government with President Suharto before. Before I was in this job, while I was still governor of California, President Nixon asked me to do a mission for him. Took me there.
When was that exactly?
19? It would have been around 71 or 72. But they've never been to Bali.
So you're looking forward to it?
Yes. Heavens, we even have songs about Bali in our country.
I hope you enjoy it.
I'm sure I will. Thank you for coming in. Well, I think he's one of the world's great statesmen.
So can you talk about terrorism when you're in Bali?
Talk about
terrorism.
Oh, I'm quite sure that subject will be, yes. I'm sure we'll talk about that, as well as the economic situation and our trade relationship, because, you know, your part of the world is the fastest growing economic.
It's really normal.
Well,
I'd like to know from the U.S.
Well, maybe it's the slowing down that just comes from once you reach a certain plateau. There's a fast recovery. Your time, but then it levels off to just normal growth. But we've been twice in Singapore.
When was that?
Well, let's see, both of those trips were back in the early 70s.
I think you should make another one. Change quite a great thing.
Was that?
The profile has changed quite a bit.
Oh,
yes. Well, it looks a different. Building so fast and rebuilding so fast.
I was impressed with the cleanliness of your downtown streets.
I think it was good.
Which I understand. Well, sorry to keep you waiting here, but now we're going to be very busy in the other side of the world and we'll be readily available to work with on a matter that we've been accustomed to. This is complicated further by your being busy with a few things that I think you have placed up there on the hill. So I'm just going to touch on a few points and ask George to get into some more detail. First, the economic summit itself is a unique opportunity to advance the causes of political and economic self-determination. And I'm hopeful our allies will join us in moving forward in the spirit of cooperation. But the second issue is Saudi arms sales. You must understand that
I'm fully committed to providing those arms, none of which are new to the Saudi inventory, and that I need your active support to make that delivery possible. If I get a resolution of disapproval on my desk, I'll veto. And the thing is, we're trying in every way to keep a relationship where we can be helpful in the overall peace process over there. We're already seen too much by the moderate Arab states as just being so totally in support of Israel that we can't make a fair decision. Every time we do something like this, like even the Jordan arms sales, it just adds to that whole impression. Now, we have the word with the Israelis. They can't ever come out and support something of this kind because technically there has never been a peace declared between the Arab nations. So they can't come out. But at the same time, we know from talking to Peres, this does not, he knows why we're doing it. He knows that, and has confidence that in us, that if ever anyone should turn around and attempt to use these against Israel, we would be there to offset it. And now another thing I want to mention here is aid to the countries. I want to leave you with some sobering information in that regard. New Soviet rock arms are now being delivered, and time is running out for the resistance. As a matter of fact, we have heard that they are faced with great shortages up to it, including having to cut their food rations right now. So time is really going to be of the essence. And either we do what's necessary now, or we face more painful decisions in the future. And these, I don't know whether you've seen some of that back there when that was hot on the news wires and the TV news. These are mainly young people. They're volunteers, and their heart and soul invested in what they're doing. I think they deserve better than sitting there on half rations and without enough ammunition to really, in any extended period, defend themselves. Lastly, I hope the Senate will proceed to ratify the U.S.-UK extradition treaty as soon as possible. I've sent you a letter emphasizing how important this is in our fight against terrorism, and it really is. In fact, some of the latest briefings on terrorist groups that have been helped fund-wise and so forth by Mr. Gaddafi include the provisional IRA. And that's not the IRA of such emotional history to Ireland from back in the days of their battles with Britain. This is literally a terrorist group, and it's using that name as an offshoot. And for them to be able to commit murder and then come to the United States for shelter, and for us to refuse to extradite, I think is something that we should make a correction. But that's enough for me, George, if you like to.
Mr. President, I think you've said
before we leave anyway. Earlier this week on Tuesday, we covered the political issues that were likely to arise in your bilateral meetings in Tokyo. And we've had a couple of special that have been working with the Sherpas from the other countries over the past several months are going to go over the economic issues that they've been working on, and it will be the subject of.
Beyond that, the Japanese have put themselves out to accept almost any suggestion that we made of whether or not the other countries like it. So we've had a few to be convinced that all the press will come to our press place and ignore theirs, which is flattering and will have been good. The other interesting angle on this summit is the Mitterrand Chirac team. Iran has said he wants Chirac to be treated like a prime minister if he comes, but of course he wants to be treated like a president, and if he can't treat him. Will not arrive in Tokyo till just after lunch the first full day, Monday. Then that lunch is scheduled to be with the heads with the foreign ministers. The dinner that night is scheduled to be heads alone. The Japanese probably will interchange those and make the lunch heads alone, which Chirac is not in town, so he's not being excluded, and then make the dinner with foreign ministers, and Chirac will replace their foreign minister. We told